Agreed on close consultations are necessary, as in the past, and we fully intend to stay in close touch. I would like to take this opportunity to announce, as part of our initiative to increase contacts between the German and American peoples, a high-level commission for the U.S., the United States, and German tricentennial has been formed. And this group will coordinate the many activities celebrating the 300th anniversary of the arrival of the first German settlers in America at Germantown, Pennsylvania. And Chancellor Kohl and I have just met with several distinguished Americans who are standing behind us now who have agreed to help in this effort. We'll be closely following their progress. In 1983, we will commemorate innumerable contributions made to American society by our fellow citizens of German descent, including our Secretary of State Schultz, whose forebears came from Southwest Germany. Events to celebrate the anniversary are planned by many communities in both countries. The commission will represent me throughout the commemorative, and it will be chaired by the former National Secretary of our National Security Council, Richard Allen, Charles Wick, head of the United States Information Agency, Chief Justice Warren Burger, and other distinguished Americans who have agreed to play a part. One of the high points of the celebration will take place in Philadelphia in October 83 at a gala banquet, which both President Carstens of the Federal Republic of Germany and I hope to attend. And the United States Congress is marking the occasion. The Senate has passed, and there is now before the House a joint resolution proclaiming 1983 as German-American Tricentennial Year. I'm sure that the commemoration of the deep and lasting friendship between our two countries will be a great success. And again, let me just say it's been a great pleasure to welcome Chancellor Kohl here to our country again.
Herr Präsident, meine Damen und Herren, ich empfinde es als eine besonders glückliche Fügung, dass Präsident Reagan bei meinem ersten Besuch als Kanzler in der Bundesrepublik Deutschland in USA heute die Konstituierung einer besonderen Kommission für die 300-Jahr-Feier deutsch-amerikanischer Beziehungen bekannt gibt.
Mr. President, I consider it to be a most happy coincidence that today, on my first visit to the United States as Federal Chancellor, President Reagan has announced the appointment of a special commission on the tricentennial of German-American relations.
Was wir im nächsten Jahr gemeinsam feierlich begehen wollen, ist nicht nur die Erinnerung an die Einwanderung von 13 Familien aus der deutschen Stadt Krefeld. Wir feiern ein intensives und fruchtbares Geben und Nehmen zwischen Deutschen und Amerikanern, zwischen Deutschland und Amerika, durch drei Jahrhunderte hindurch.
What we will be commemorating together next year is not merely the immigration of 13 families from the German city of Krefeld. We will also be celebrating an intensive and fruitful relationship of give and take between Germany and America extending over three centuries.
Sie, Herr Präsident, haben von den Deutschen gesprochen, die zum Aufbau ihres großen und freien Landes beigetragen haben. Ihr Land Amerika hat diesen Beitrag vielfach zurückgegeben.
You, Mr. President, have spoken of the Germans who have helped to build this great and free country. America, your country, has repaid that contribution many times over.
Ich erinnere an den Katalog der Menschen- und Freiheitsrechte in der amerikanischen Bill of Rights. Sie war Vorbild für den ersten Versuch einer freiheitlich-demokratischen Verfassung für Deutschland im Jahre 1948. Und unser Grundgesetz, die Verfassung der Bundesrepublik Deutschland, hat den Katalog der Grundrechte zur Grundlage unseres Verfassungs- und unseres Rechtssystems gemacht.
I call to mind the catalog of human rights and freedoms embodied in your Bill of Rights. It served as a model for the first attempt to set up a free and democratic constitution in Germany in 1848. And our present constitution, the Basic Law, used that same catalog of fundamental rights as the foundation for our constitutional and legal system.
Und Herr Präsident, ich erinnere daran, dass in dunklen Jahren unserer deutschen Geschichte Hunderttausende von Deutschen in Amerika Zuflucht und Exil fanden. Für viele von ihnen nenne ich Karl Schurz, Walter Gropius, Thomas Mann und Albert Einstein.
I recall that in the dark years of Germany's history, hundreds of thousands of Germans found refuge in America. And I will mention only Karl Schurz, Walter Gropius, and Thomas Mann, and Albert Einstein, who represent so many more.
Nach zwei großen Kriegen, in denen sich Deutsche und Amerikaner gegenüberstanden, haben wir Deutsche Amerikas größte Tugend erfahren: Hilfsbereitschaft und Großzügigkeit.
Following two great wars, in which Germans and Americans were adversaries, we Germans came to experience the greatest virtue of the Americans, their generosity and their desire to help.
Ich sprach heute schon in meiner Begrüßungsansprache davon. Meine Generation erinnert sich mit Dankbarkeit an das Hoover-Hilfswerk und an die Care-Pakete. Und ohne den Marshallplan wäre der rasche Wiederaufbau meines Landes nicht möglich gewesen.
In my remarks responding to your address of welcome, Mr. President, I referred to the fact that my generation remembers with gratitude the Hoover Aid Program and the care parcels, and without the Marshall Plan, the speedy recovery of my country would not have been possible.
Heute sind unser geistiges und kulturelles Leben, sind Wissenschaft und Forschung geprägt durch vielfältigen Austausch. Viele meiner Landsleute kennen und schätzen Ernest Hemingway, John Steinbeck, Thornton Wilder, und unsere jungen Leute lesen Susan Sontag, um nur einige Namen zu nennen.
Today, relations between our two countries are characterized by a wide variety of exchanges in the fields of culture, science and research. Every German knows Ernest Hemingway, John Steinbeck and Thornton Wilder. And young people in our country read Susan Sontag, to name only a few.
Herr Präsident, meine Damen und Herren, der Presidential Commission, lassen Sie uns die Geschichte zu einer Verpflichtung für die Gegenwart und für die Zukunft machen. Für uns, für die Generation unserer Kinder und für die folgenden Generationen. Das ist unsere Verantwortung in unseren Tagen.
Mr. President, members of the Presidential Commission, let us make the past an obligation for the future, for ourselves and for the next generation of our children and their children. This is our responsibility in these days. Thank you very much.
And